All right, May 5th, 2022. We'll check out the grass real quick. It is growing. I noticed it yesterday. Yeah, we've totally got some grass growing. I'm gonna check over here as well, just to see if it's consistent. Yeah, we got grass over here, we got grass here. Looks like it's growing. It's just off to a slow start because of the colder temperatures, but yeah, I think we're good. All right, it rained, so the ground's nice and damp. Don't even have to water this morning. All right, so let me show you what's going on in the shop right now. We're gonna go ahead and at Home Depot, we have to pick up a drain unclogger or a snake or something because that is plugged up. I found out after it rained, so we're gonna clean all that up down there. I don't even know what that is. I think the wind blew it down there. We'll fix all that up when we get back. That's gotta be a priority actually. And then last night after I shut the camera off, I finished framing this partition out. And then I did some research on the pocket doors. So I already ordered the pocket doors and the soft stop rails and everything, that like the accessories for the doors. I ordered them from Home Depot. We have to go pick that stuff up. So we're gonna head over there as soon as I'm done explaining what needs to be done. So as far as the door itself goes, I was thinking about building some doors. I've got plenty of 2x6s, and that should be enough wood right there to build two doors. However, I do not have a table saw, and I'm afraid that my work wouldn't be 100% without the table saw. So if they have doors, we'll go ahead and purchase doors. I have to frame this out to be 4.5 inches higher than whatever doors I choose. And it has to be framed out width-wise. So say I get a 36 inch door, I have to go 36 inches times 2 plus 1 inch is where this needs to be framed out to. I guess we'll go to Home Depot, see what they have, and then we can work on framing this stuff out. So here at Home Depot, just looking at doors, this is a 36 by 80 hardwood slab door. I mean, that's a decent price for the amount of effort it would take to build one of these and the time it would take. I think this is the way to go. Yeah, right here is the pocket door. I ordered them online. It is the 1500 series soft close pocket frame. So these pine slab doors are a lot higher quality, obviously. 32 by 80, they have the 30 by 80. And they have the even smaller ones. But these I could build. A lot heavier duty. All right, we're back from Home Depot. I got the two pocket door frames and the rest of the 2x4s that we're gonna need to finish framing out these shelves. So I was doing some thinking about the door itself. Now I could build my own doors, which is what I think I'm gonna attempt. Cause I'm gonna do, you know, the doors would be standard 1 3/8 inch thick. These are 1.5, so I'll have room to plane these down and make them perfect. I do not have a table saw, but I do have a circular saw, so I can, you know, I can work with that, I think. The doors, I think we're gonna go 30 inches instead of the 36. If we go 30 inches, that'll bring us 30 inches back in. It'll take us to the second stud back, plus a little bit more, about an inch past that, for the frame for the pocket door. It has to be 80. If I do an 80 inch door, the frame has to be, the header has to be at 84 inches for the top of the door. So I think that's what we're gonna do. 30 inch doors, that's big enough. That's fine, that's plenty good. Yeah, that'll be great. And not only that, but the narrower the, another plus about having a smaller door means more wall space, right? So yeah, 30 inches, we can do 30 inches over there as well. Three more boxes arrived today, so we're still missing one box of black sand from Cape Disappointment, which is, I'm surprised on how fast the first one got here yesterday, and the other three got here today, and we're still missing one. My pack job didn't hold up as good as I thought. It looks like I forgot to wrap packing tape around this corner. I know I got some on this side, but I guess I, unless it ripped off somehow, or, I don't know. I got a lot of black sand though. I'll be good for a little while at least for the impossible bags. All right, let's go ahead and start working on this and finally get these partitions up. Okay, so just a reminder, I've never done this before, so let me know what you think. If you see anything that's completely wrong, I mean, I understand there's a few, I mean, carpentry isn't guitar making. However, it's important to have at least the right measurements. I did notice when I was putting in these studs, right? There was like one that was a little bit higher than the rest, and I cut it to 91 and a half instead of 91 and a quarter. So it was a quarter inch higher, and it was a pretty big difference, right? So, I mean, other than stuff like that, I think I'm doing all right as far as winging it. I have everything tied into studs as far as the stuff that's connected to the walls, such as over here. And that's all connected to the walls. The bottom plate over here, you can see that the very bottom is pressure treat, and then right above it is some regular 2x4s and then more pressure treat. So that top piece of pressure treat doesn't need to be there. That should be just regular 2x4s like this one. However, I had leftover pressure treat. I had no other use for it. It was a little bit twisted, and I figured if I put it there, it would, you know, the pressure, the constant pressure on it and nailing it down a bunch would straighten it out, making it a usable piece of wood. Otherwise, it would have been sitting on the pile for who knows how long, right? So let me show you where we're at. All right, so we have the door framed out. It goes straight to concrete here. I had to put a little bottom plate and piece of pressure treat there just so I could have this on up against the wall. I wanted to have it basically framed out just as I would have done any other partition here. So this is the header for the door. This is 84 and a half inches from the floor. The door is 80 inches, and I'm supposed to frame out 4.5 inches above, and then the width is supposed to be double the width of the door plus 1 inch. So it's 20, a 30 inch door, 61. So 61 inches to there. I did not start in over here yet. I might continue doing that tonight, or I might just save that till tomorrow. Basically what I have to do is I have to widen this out to the same thing, 61, bring it up to 84, frame it out the same way that I did that. And then we can start installing the pocket doors wherever the other one is. Here, oh, I already unboxed it. So this is the rail on the top. This gets installed on the top. And this is what the door slides on. See the little hooks where the door is actually going to hang onto it. I also have the little soft close sliding door hardware. And I got a little, an edge pull for each one. As far as doorknob or handle or whatever you want to call it, we'll figure that out when the time comes. But I think that's all I'm going to do for today. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, hit the thumbs up, and I will see you tomorrow. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.